This is Ms. Cox, and today I'm going to teach you the basics of using Scratch 2.0. So the first thing is you have several different areas of your screen when you're in Scratch. First off, this is in a browser, which is great. You used to have to actually download the program and run it from your computer. Now we have the same basic functions, but a few things have changed. So first off, in this area here where the cat is, this is your screen of, basically the screen of your game, what things would look like in the game. Down here we have sprites, which are basically your characters for your animation or for your game. There's a backdrop here, and right now I don't have any backdrop. You can have some different backgrounds this way by taking a picture, creating your own, uploading, or choosing a background from the library. And then over here is the most important area. This is where all the coding is going to go. And the great thing is the coding is all done through these little blocks. So you have several different options here for these blocks. Well, actually more than several, you have a ton of different options, which is what makes Scratch so fabulous. And all you need to do is click and drag over the block you would like to use. To see what that does to your character, you have to just double click on it, and you'll see as I double click on it, it will move my cat forward 10 steps. Now, if you want to move the cat backwards, you just make that a negative. Now, when I double click, he'll go backwards. Now, there's a lot more you can do than that. There's turning the cat a certain number of degrees, which is kind of cool. You can have him point in a certain direction or go to a specific place on the screen. But for now, let's go ahead and take a look at some other options. There's one thing you can do, which is add sounds. And right now there's a sound already built in, and it's a cat's meow. So let's see. Yes, I don't know if you could, I don't think you could hear that, but it meows. To get that to actually meow for you, let's go to sound and play sound meow. And if you double click on that, it will play the sound. Now, I could have that connected to this block so that every time the cat moves backwards, it will meow. Now, let's talk about some other cool stuff here. In control, there's some really cool options. The repeat and forever loops are very important. And you'll see there's a little arrow at the bottom. That's because it loops whatever the code is inside. So if I use repeat, it will loop whatever's inside that number of times. So here, if I double click, my cat will move back and the sound will play 10 times. Now, that's great, but you may realize, let me get those out of there. You may realize you want something to go forever. So the forever loop basically will just keep doing, I'm gonna move my cat so you can see. It will keep doing that motion. Whoop, there he goes. All right. So that's really the basics of motion. And really control is where you're going to get all those loops. Motion is really all about movement, and then sound is where you get those different sound options. And there are some cool ones besides actual sounds like meows. There is a drum option, and there's all sorts of different sounds actually built in, and you can change how long you want that to play for. So take a minute, experiment with motion, control, and sound, and then keep watching the video after that, and I'll talk about some more fun stuff. All right, it's time to talk about some new techniques. Let's take a look at events. Events are very important. One is this when flag is clicked, and basically that's like when the game starts. So the flag is like, hey, start the game, you click the flag. So, let me bring my cat back. So what you can do is link that to something. For example, let's go back to this. So instead of just clicking on this step, I would actually click on the flag over here, and then the cat will move back because I've linked that when flag clicked to move backwards. There's other things though, especially if you want to make games, you will really want to be able to use this when space key pressed, and you can change this to any key. So for example, maybe when the up arrow is pressed, maybe I want my cat to, let's have the Y, we'll have him move up by 10. Let's see what that looks like. There's the up arrow, I'm pressing the up arrow and my cat goes up. I might do the same thing when the down arrow is pressed. Maybe I want my cat to move down. And to do that, I would do Y, change Y by, and I'm going to choose a negative number here, negative 10. So now I can move my cat up and down. So those are very helpful tools. Those arrow key, using arrow keys or really any key, can be very helpful in a game if you want to make a game to move your character around. Now, one thing you might get sick of is the cat. You might want a different sprite. To create a new sprite, you have several options here. You can create a sprite from the library, and there's lots of built-in sprites, but you may not like any of these. You can also paint your own sprite. So there's a little paint tool here. You can create your own. You can upload one, and you can also take one from a camera. Now, let me go ahead and just create a new sprite. That's frightening. Let's go with the starfish. All right, so now I've got this scary starfish here. He is a little frightening. There's another thing you might want to be able to do, which is add a new sound. So just like you can add new sprites, you can add new sounds this way. And what's nice is you can choose sounds from a library, just like some of the images, and there's tons of different sounds built in for you to already use. Or you can record your own sound, which is nice too. Now, that's how to add sounds and sprites. Let me pause for a second. Try adding a sprite, try adding a sound, and see if you can do those things, and you might try painting your own. Try that out, and you'll notice when you do that, the code has disappeared here. The code is dependent on the sprite. So here I'm clicked on the cat sprite, and here's all the code for the cat. But the starfish, so far I have no code for the starfish. So each sprite or each character, however you want to think about it, in your game or animation has separate controls. So it has separate programming that you have to do for each character or sprite. So try that out right now and then start up the recording again. The last few basics I'm going to go over now are looks, and we're also going to take a look at, at looks actually, that's it. So first, I'm going to go back to my cat for a minute because he has several different costumes built in. So if I click on the costumes tab here, you'll see he has two costumes, costume one and costume two. And what's nice about these is it kind of makes him look like he's running, but you don't really want to have to click back and forth. You want programming to do it for you. So one of the things I'm going to do, instead of when the flag is clicked, move negative 10 steps. Let's do this. When the flag is clicked, I will have him move forward 10 steps. And then I'm going to have, under looks, I'll have him switch the costume to costume 2. Go away. Let's try setting up our cat so our cat actually just keeps walking. So let's have it switch back and forth between the costumes forever. So I'll have the repeat command in here. Oh, actually, we need the forever command. Go away. So forever, once the flag is clicked, we'll have it switch to the first costume and then switch back to the second costume. Now, the thing is, if we don't put a gap in here, it's probably going to not work very well. So let's take a look and see what happens. Can we see? Right now, even though this is running, we cannot see it changing because there's no gap between the costume switching. So I'm going to go over here to wait 1 second, and I'm going to put that in between. And actually, we don't probably need a full second. Let's go with a half second. So now let's try it. Now, there's a different problem. If you take a look, it's kind of twitching because it's waiting between this costume and this costume, but then when it repeats to the top, it is not waiting again. So we actually need to put a second wait time in here of 0.5 seconds. Now, you'll see, he looks kind of like he's running. Play around with this. Those are the basics. I don't think there's too much more you need to know. One other cool thing is you can have your cat talk. I could have him say hi when the flag is clicked. Hello. Anyway, play with this, have fun with it. And once you're done playing with the basic tools, it's time to start making some games. Thank you very much.